Miss Evelyn?
Hi, scientist. It is Evelyn. Thanks for helping me feel a little less stuck at home today. You know, I know that it's pretty late, but is it okay for us to do our thing?
Of course, Evelyn. It's my pleasure. Thanks for having me so late at night, but that means that we get to see all of these beautiful stars and even make constellations out of them.
Cool. I have been super excited thinking about being able to see stars and constellations and you being able to point some stuff out to me. So I actually want to show you something. Can I show you?
Of course.
Okay, but I need to turn off the light, so give me 1 second, okay?
Okay.
I'm running to do this. Hope that's dark enough. My computer gives a lot of glare. Okay, so I've been thinking about it. So I have this flashlight that lets me show some constellations on my own wall, so I can make constellations on the inside of my home. And then I thought, what if I got to design my own constellation? And because I was so excited, I made a happy face.
That's so cool, Evelyn.
I love it. Now, if anybody else, or if you want to try to make your own constellation at home, you need a flashlight. In my case, I used a toilet paper tube and some paper, and I punched out some holes using a toothpick. But you could probably use a paper cup or other stuff, and then you can try to make your constellation big or small, and you get to play with it a little bit more. But anyways, I just got really excited and I decided to make them, and I really wanted to show you. But you can show me what you were planning to show me. I'm ready.
All right, Evelyn, so I'm going to show you a program to point out things in the night sky. And then hopefully you can think back on this when you're making observations yourself when you look out your window, okay?
Cool. I'm ready.
Awesome. So one thing that you'll notice is that right now it's not actually night. And that's because the sun is up in the sky. Kind of obvious, right? Well, I'm going to make the sun set. And as the sun sets, what do you see up in the night sky?
It starts to get darker, and I see one thing that I know pretty well.
Can you point it out for me?
The moon!
The moon, yeah! So the moon is up in the night sky, and along with it, we begin to see all these other lights, which are stars. So the reason that we can't see stars during the day isn't because they're not there, but it's because they're not visible to us because the sun's light is drowning all of them out.
Cool. So what you're saying is that they're always there, we just can't always see them.
Mm-hmm, because the sun's so bright. So it's, you know, like when you have that one person who's really loud and it drowns out the noise of everyone else, that's kind of like the sun during the day.
Cool.
So, but though, we do see the sun a little bit during the night, and that's when it reflects off the moon. So I know that we think the moon is really bright, and that's because it's just bouncing off the sun's light. And it just tells us that, remember, the sun's not gone. It's just that the Earth is rotating, and so the sun's not visible to us right now. Now, when people think about bright objects to see up in the night sky, we often think of only the moon and the stars, but there are also planets we can see. And so right now, it is 11 p.m. at night, and by then I'd be asleep. But maybe you'll still be awake to see these guys, Evelyn. So I'm going to fast forward a little bit more.
I go to bed pretty early, too.
Oh, you go to bed early, too?
Maybe on the weekend.
Maybe on the weekends, or maybe for some of, you know, the people who might be up really late. Up at around 1 a.m. or so, you'll start to see Saturn and Jupiter, these planets, rise up in the night sky as well. Now, as we mentioned, though, we don't want to stay up that late. So another thing that we can do instead, it's going to take a little bit of time, but later in the year, Saturn and Jupiter will start to rise up a lot earlier, so that way we can see them at 8 p.m. instead of at 1 a.m.
That sounds much more doable.
Right, so I'll call you around that time, Evelyn. We can look at Saturn and Jupiter together.
Awesome.
So another thing that we talked about, or that you mentioned, was constellations. So I can start to point out the constellations that we see up in the night sky. Constellations are shapes that humans have invented, basically, when they looked up and played connect the dot with each of the stars, making shapes and stories about them. And so here are some of the pictures that people saw when they looked up at the night sky. Now, these are some of the pictures that some people in the world, some people in one part of the world saw. Different people around the world saw different shapes up in the night sky, because remember, everyone's different. So even though it's the same night sky that they're looking at, they saw very different things, which I think is really cool.
Like the constellation I made up.
Yeah, exactly. So there might be a smiley face constellation that someone made up maybe thousands of years ago, and you're seeing it yourself now too. Now, one constellation I did want to point out is this one here called Scorpio. Now, Scorpio is a constellation that is part of a story with Orion the Hunter. Now, what happens is that if you look right now, we don't see Orion the Hunter up in the night sky. And that's because we're in the May night sky. These are the stars that we see that are visible to us in May. But if I jump forward 6 months, which, you know, with my time machine, I can do too, to November 29th, you'll see this guy up instead, and that's Orion. Have you heard of Orion before, Evelyn?
I've heard of Orion's belt.
Yeah, so Orion's belt is those three stars that you see kind of lined up in a row, and then right beneath it, you can actually see Orion's sword. These are all stars that you can see up in the November night sky. Now, what happens is that Orion is part of a myth. He actually has a lot of versions about his myth, but the one I remember most was that he was a very famous hunter who boasted that he could hunt every animal in the world. And Gaia didn't like that. I didn't like that either. He might hunt me. So Gaia sent Scorpio, a scorpion, after him. And so if you look right here, as Orion sets in this winter night sky in November, you'll start to see Scorpio rise up in the night sky. That's not really night anymore because the sun is up. And so it looks like Scorpio is chasing Orion across the sky.
But it only looks like he's chasing it because we are constantly moving around the sun. So the stars that we can see during the summer are different than the stars that we see in the winter.
You're exactly right, Evelyn. So even though, as you said, it looks like it, remember that as the Earth orbits around the sun, the stars that we see, stars that are visible to us, are different as well. But that means that the stars that you see right now in the winter sky, you'll always be able to see during winter. And the stars that we saw in May, we'll always be able to see during May as well.
Cool. So if I want to see something specific, I just need to know when it's visible and I can plan for being able to see them. So if I want to see something and have it visible earlier, maybe I just need to figure out the time of the year.
Yep, you're exactly right. In fact, that's how scientists are able to predict when stars are where, because there's this pattern as we orbit around the sun.
Cool. Well, it's getting late now.
It's also my bedtime, so I gotta go to sleep, Evelyn. But I hope you had fun and that when you're making those observations, as you said, you'll think about what time of day it is and what day of the year it is as well.
Awesome. Well, thank you again, and thanks for helping me feel a little less stuck at home. See you next time.
See you next time.
Be sure to visit our website Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. for more stuck-at-home science activities.